Who's been waiting for this kit? I know I have. Remember my Stingray build? Well, this is the partner bike, the Schwinn Continental 10-speed racer from the folks at MPC. This is in 1/8 scale, so it makes for a pretty big kit. You can see it includes a lot of options on there. There's that Stingray that I built. I'll link to that video at the end. We got a child seat, a mirror, a headlight, a thermos, vinyl seat, tool bag, an air pump, all as options and more in this package. So let's take a look at everything. When you get yours, we're gonna get the red styrene out first. This one is molded in red. Mine is molded in red. Now you could leave the plastic as is, clear coat it, or leave it and build it as it is. You'd have a nice looking model, but we know that I'm going to paint it. There's the nice frame. Looks sturdy being 1/8 scale. We got our chains drive, which is nice that it's all on one on its own. We can get that metallicized and paint it up. Sharp looking, nice detail. We got the front fork, got that nice bend going forward. We got where it slips into the neck. We've got the child seat with belts on the back. Remember all the kids in the neighborhood that had to drive their mom or to their dad's 10-speed and have the child seat on the back, those plastic child seats? We got a nice bedroll here. Molding on that, we can put that together and detail it. You don't have to add the options, they're just a choice on there. And we've got some more decoration. We've got the thermos here. We've got what looks like more child seat parts. Not sure what these are. We'll find out what these are in a little bit. Looks like they mount around the frame somewhere to mount something, so we'll be interesting to find out what that does. This has got a lot of chrome in it. We got our luggage rack on the back. I love that. We got our handlebars. You'll have to do some hand painting. We got our baby seat parts. We got headlight parts. Check out that chain guard, the sprocket guard there. We've got our fenders in chrome. You can paint those up if you wish. We've got all a bunch of fine detail. I don't see any flash worth worrying about. All that'll snip off pretty easy. The chrome looks nice too. Because it's 1/8 scale, it doesn't look as toyish. We got these beautiful spoked wheels, 26-inch wheels, brake handles, reflectors, air pump, kickstand. Look at the size of that kickstand, those wheels. You could imagine the size of this bike. We got another chrome tree with the other half of the wheels, front and rear. We got our pedals, all nice molded in one piece. You don't have to fight with those. We've got our brake calipers, front and rear brakes. We've got what looks like the generator for the optional headlight. Awesome sauce. I love the detailing on those wheels. Not a lot of parts to it. Doesn't take a lot of work. We got a nice little decal sheet. These are the reflectors on the pedals. We've got the star emblems. The Schwinn Continental is in white and black, depending on what color you're going to paint yours. The head logo and the logo on the bar underneath the seat. That's all on that decal sheet. And we have some vinyl parts here. We've got some nice black flexible vinyl tubing, hollow inside, presses on all those fittings. You can use that for the brake lines, the shifter lines. It's got front rear shifters and front rear brake with a cutout guide in the manual for that line. We've got the nice tires here. I don't see a brand name molded into the tires at all. Just not seeing it. They're very skinny. Not going to be sanding these or anything. That would kind of, that might deform them. They've got a groove on the inside for the wheels. And finally, we've got our nice little Ziploc, or a nice little snap bag like I had on the Stingray, and the vinyl seat. Flexible, looks the part, it's got the frame underneath it. You could paint if you desired. They were black on most of the ones that I remember. So that is all of that, and the little fold-out manual. I'm going to get to putting mine together, and we'll come right back. Give yourself an hour at best if you've ever glued a kit together, and you're going to have this thing ready for the paint department if you choose to paint it. I've assembled some things that I'm not going to be using on the build, but I still wanted you to see them so that you could see how they work. That is the child seat for the back of the bike. Now, I'm not going to be painting it or anything, but I did want to assemble it because the instructions might be a little off. So you can see how it goes together. The instructions are fine, but they might be a little hard to understand abstractly if you're not going to use it. So this is the seat. It would sit on the back on top of the luggage rack right there. And these would come down to the bars of the luggage rack and glue into place above the fender. This here, the leg guard, this would come down off the front of that luggage rack and sit below it like so. with the chain guard on either side. This one just fell off because I've got them loosely super glued in place. They just go on the sides. But your child seat then would sit on the back of the bike like so and look every bit the part of that. Now, I'm not putting that on mine, but I glued it together, spent some time on it just so you guys could see how it's going to look. I'm going to be using the Thermos model. I love it. It still needs its chrome cap, which I won't be painting, but this will be going on the bike, so I'm going to get that painted up, glued together, and set to go. I love the bedroll. I don't know if I'm going to be using it, but I glued it all together. I'm going to get it painted, and by the end of the build, I'll decide if it's going to be going on the luggage rack, because I'm using the luggage rack for sure. This little storage, this vinyl storage compartment, would go on the front of the handlebars. Not going to be using it, but wanted to glue it together with some super glue, just so you could see how it would look and how it will sit positioned off those handlebars like so, as a nice little storage thing, a little toolkit. The vinyl seat's ready to go as is. We don't need to do anything with it, so we'll just toss that on the side and wait to get done. The chain and sprocket are all set to go. We can get this painted up in a black color. We can color our chain a little bit, and that will be all done. That will just press into place. All set to go with the chain tensioner back there and everything. Just needs a little bit of flash cleanup. The frame itself is all glued together. Now you'll see a little bit of cloudiness in various areas. What I like to do is I like to put model cement in there so I know it will melt the plastic, and I tack weld it into place with a little bit of super glue. On chrome parts, super glue will cloud chrome parts, especially if you end up using more than you should, which I do quite a bit. A nice trick with that is if you get too much cloudiness on your chrome and you want it to stay chrome, just rub some future floor polish on it with a brush. Two or three coats of it laid over there and let dry, laid over and let dry, will diminish most of that cloudiness till it's non-existent. We'll be using that trick later. But these parts, I want it to look like the cover. I like the colored fenders instead of the chrome, so I attach those to the frame as is. We'll get that all primed black and then paint it in our final color coat all together as one. Now mine was short shot, which means not all the plastic was molded for the bar across the top, so I did have to use a substantial amount of glue. It looks bad because of the cloudiness, but once the paint's on it, it's not going to be an issue. You can see all those two parts go together. The neck does not have to be glued. I love that. This will just slide in to the neck there. And we got our front fork and its fender all glued together. So we'll be able to separate those, grab onto that neck and paint it, grab onto that seat post, because the seat post, we're going to use some tester silver to make it metal. We'll get that whole frame painted up. One of the coolest things about the kit is these giant wheel and tire package. And guess what? You can leave the chrome alone. You don't have to get on any glue. You don't have to get on any future. If you screw the glue up, the tire that I showed you are grooved through the center. You just put the two wheel halves together, space your spokes out so they're even, and then snap the wheel over the top. Just snap it on like an O-ring all the way around. Holds the whole assembly together. You can tell it's very strong. We can let it fall. It's not going to ever come loose. It's like being held together by a giant rubber band. It looks fantastic. And those are ready to go. They will attach in here. And on the rear axle, you just spread that out and put those in the holes, and you're all set to go. So we are done with the wheel and tire package, which on the Stingray was a little bit of gluing, and I had to repaint them. So I'm going to get all these little parts that I'm using over to paint. The chrome parts here will stay chrome. We got our kickstand, our air pump, which are all metallic, our gear shift. I'll be doing black washes after I attach these to the bike with super glue. We'll get in there with some Tamiya black wash and attack those parts and let them look nice. I will be hand painting the pedals and the foam covering on the handlebars with some Tamiya paints that I know will cling to that chrome really well. Craft paint will go over chrome, but it tends to rub off super easy, so Tamiya paint will stick much stronger. I'll get this stuff in paint, and then we'll start the detail section. After all the details, I just whip out the dollar store super glue, little container of CA activator, which is what dollar store super glue is. It's cyanoacrylate glue. We've got the decals left. We've got the seat, the air pump, the cool old dad style thermos. I am going to use the bedroll. I was able to make it look really nice with that, make it look like an old army blanket bedroll. I accented everything with a brown felt tip marker and some brown wash. These are just cheap felt tip markers you can get in giant sets from like Hobby Lobby. I use these all the time for detailing. They're the house brand. You just buy them, you got a gajillion colors in there, and they do a good job. They have the super fine line, and they have the nice thick side, and they last long enough to be worth the small amount of money you spend on them. Anatomia brown panel line accent color all the way around makes that bedroll look amazing with the black undercoat of primer, and then over the top that olive drab color. That's going to look outstanding on its little flat panel there on the back of the bike. It's going to look great. I'm loving that. I didn't add the little front purse. I didn't add the child seat. I didn't do the headlights or anything like that. I didn't like it. I just didn't want them on my bike. I wouldn't put them on my bike for real. So I want to build it up as I want to see it. Got all my lines cut. The decals will be one of the last things I do. I'll be using the white ones, of course, on the red, but you could use whatever color you want. Getting everything on there. But otherwise, we've got it all assembled here. Minus the accoutrement. We got the little shifters in place. We got the luggage rack. Kickstand, which I glued into place so it always holds it. The chain looks awesome back there. It actually looks like a real chain and gear shift now on a real bike. The wheel and tire package. I'm so glad I painted the fenders. Got our brakes in place, front and rear. You can see them hiding underneath there. Got those lined up so we can get our 10-speed stopped. Got those combo brake levers on there. Everything glued in nicely with just a little bit of super glue and a little bit of activator. Now when we get to the point where we're putting the lines on, the manual will tell you exactly where to put the lines based on how you cut them. And then of course it'll tell you where to put those very few decals so you get them on the right spots. That is it. I don't have a lot of brake line left over. This is it. So if you think you're going to be using more, you might want to get some, or you might want to go with a lighter color wire. I'm building mine right out of the box, and I love how it looked on the Stingray, and I'm going to like how it looks on here. So I am just so impressed with how nice these bike kits coming out, being as old as they are. I thought they'd be really hard and low in detail, but they're absolutely gorgeous. So when I come back, we'll have the total final. In fact, I think I'll get some panel line accent out, do around the gear guard there and stuff like that. I already did the front hub and it made it look nice, so I think I'll just accent the shifters and some of the brake levers, give them a little more depth with a panel wash, let it all dry with the decals on it, brush over the frame and the decals with a coat of future floor polish, and we'll be right back. This kind of kit is why stepping out of your comfort zone, building something instead of just always building a holy grail muscle car, try to build something else. Throw something else on the bench. It'll get you out of a slump. It'll get you out of a dry spell of, oh, I always build the same thing and you're getting kind of bored. Grab something like this. It goes together so nicely, even though it looks, it is quite delicate, but it goes together really really nicely. It's well designed, well engineered. Now I brushed on a coat of future floor polish over the chrome pieces that had super glue on them and over the apple red paint, and she is gleaming now like a nice new bike that you're getting out to go and ride. I love that little pack on the back. Adds a little bit of scale detail. The little thermos, the air pump, all necessities sitting on its nice kickstand. We got our handlebars, those 10-speed handlebars. I remember trying to ride some friends every once in a while and always screwing up the brake levers and all that, grabbing them at the wrong thing and all that, because my bike was a red Huffy where you pressed backwards on the coaster brake to stop it. This thing goes together super nice. I'm so glad that the wheel and the tire package go together without a drop of glue and then just snap into place. Everything else paints up super easy. You can see how I got that frame together, got paint on it, got it all pushed together, got the neck together. Nothing broke, nothing snapped off. None of the hoses or wires came loose. We didn't have all kinds of problems getting stuff together. No, you can see the cables pushed right on their locators. We ran them down to where they should be. We routed them through the frame because it is a little bit of a stiffer cable, so I didn't want them sticking all over and all the way down. You could take fine pieces of tape or wire and clamp those to the frame if you wanted, but mine is built right out of the box as is. You had all those extra parts like headlights, tail light, child seat, little storage pouch for the front. Those are all cool, little generator for the headlight that would attach to the front wheel. Those are all excellent things, but this is exactly how I would want mine to look if I had a Continental 10-speed, and so that's how I build it, and you should build yours your way. That's what I tell you every single video. Build your models your way. Don't tell me how to build mine, and I won't tell you how to build yours, and we're going to have an awesome time. The decals laid down beautifully, wrapped right around the pipe. They're nice and thin on this kit, so I didn't have to heat them up or burnish them down or anything or worry about them peeling off. The minute I laid them off the sheet onto each pipe of the frame, onto the fork, onto the neck, and onto the seat area here, they just laid right down and stuck where they should. And don't forget, if you paint your bike a different color, you do have those options in black. I chose not to put the reflectors on my pedals, left them black rubber like they're a replacement pedal. So build your model your way. You can easily put this together in a weekend without much fuss. I'm going to link to the Stingray video so you can see how nicely that model goes together as well. I think you should get them as a matched pair. Down below in the description, I will link to where you can get this model on order and build it up. Make sure you grab ones like this when you can, because they come out and then they disappear for like 20 years at a time. So grab one or grab two of them, build them up your way, and have a lot of fun. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you all at the next kit review.